my name is Yasmina, and today I want to talk to you about board games. So, board games, huh? You might be thinking, is that like Monopoly? Yeah, it's exactly like Monopoly, but fun. So I have a pile of board games that I'm going to show you, and I'm going to talk a little bit about each one, and also why you should play more board games. So let's begin! So board games are honestly so much fun. They are perfect for like nights in with friends, just hanging out, you know. You're having a few drinks, you're talking, but maybe something is missing sometimes. Well, I think this is definitely one of the things that is missing and shouldn't be missing. So next time you have your friends over, you know, why not consider playing some board games? I'm gonna give you some suggestions of one of my favorites, or well, what I own right now. Alright, so let's get on to the games. So the first game I'm going to show you is one of board gaming's classics and most loved, and it is Carcassonne. I have no idea how to pronounce it properly, but I say it Carcassonne. So Carcassonne is a Euro game, and what that means is that it focuses a lot more on the mechanics and not so much on the theme. It's a tile-laid game, which means that you get piles of tiles, you don't see what the tiles are, and then you pick each one up and you try to form a pattern on the table with those tiles. And you get points depending on what you build and how you build your world with the tiles. It plays from 2 to 5 people, and there are lots of expansions to play around with as well. But this plays so quickly and it's so much fun to just have to play around the table while like you're watching a TV or something. It's really fun to have, and I highly, highly recommend this one. Carcassonne. Next one I want to show you is not so much a board game as it is a card game, and I am pretty sure a lot of you have heard of this before because this is very, very big on the internet, and it is called Cards Against Humanity. Cards Against Humanity is, as the title suggests, a card game for horrible people. Basically, if you have any sort of sense of humor, you'll have a lot of fun with this game. You have to make up phrases with the cards you're given, and basically whoever has the funniest joke and whoever can make the other people laugh the most wins the point. And it's so much fun. Everyone I've introduced this to has loved it. I will say though that if you play it a lot, you'll start seeing, you know, repeating jokes and stuff like that. So, you know, that's when the expansions sort of come in hand, because they always come up with new cards, and you can also write your own. You are given blank cards to write your own questions and your own answers, so there is a lot of replayability, but it depends on how you play. Yeah, if you want to have a great night in with your friends and have some drinks, play this game. You will cry with laughter. The third game I have to show you is called Pandemic by Zeman Games for 2 to 4 players, and this is a really interesting kind of game because it's a co-op game, so you play together with everyone else to beat the game. And the basic premise is you have to save humanity from horrible, horrible viruses that are spreading across the world, and that is obviously very, very bad, so you have to fight them and clear out the map depending on your roles and stuff like that. Very, very fun. And it does suffer from the alpha player syndrome, which means that if there's one person in the group who likes to take control a lot, he can pretty much say what everyone else should do. So you have to kind of be attentive to that and try to shut that person up pretty much so that everyone can have their own say in what they think should happen. If you want something a bit more difficult that you're not always gonna win, trust me, you will not win this easily. There you go. Pandemic. Next game is called Jaipur, and this is strictly for 2 people. It's a trading card sort of game where you and your opponent compete against each other to be the Maharaja's best personal trader. Basically buy and sell goods like silks, spices, camels. It's really, really fast. Again, fantastic for 2 people when you have that night in and you just want to watch something in the background and have this on the table. It's super, super fast and really fun. The art is beautiful on this, and yeah. Jaipur. Next game is kind of a big one, and it's called Small World by Days of Wonder. This is a fantasy-themed war game in which you fight to control areas on the map with different races, but the twist is that every race has different abilities, and at the start of each game, those race traits and abilities are randomly selected, so every time you get a new combination, and so it has a lot of replay value. This was the first board game I bought, and it was a pretty big hit with my group of friends, so I would highly recommend you check this one as well. Next comes the smallest game in my collection, but as we all know, size doesn't always matter. But this is Hanabi. And this little game won best board game of the year in 2013. And for such a small game, that is a really big compliment. It's a 2-4 people game. And again, it is a co-op game, meaning that you play with each other to beat the game. In this game, you are trying to build fireworks, and it works in a kind of solitaire sort of way where you have to build numbers from 1 to 5 in order. But the catch is that you don't see what cards you have in your hand. You hold them with the numbers facing the other person and they do the same, so you can see their cards and they can see yours. The idea is you have to give hints to each other in order to figure out what cards you have in your hand, and then you can make decisions upon those hints on how to play, on how to win the game. But you only have a limited number of hints you can give, so again, this one is really difficult to win. I have not won it yet. I haven't played it that much, but I haven't won it. And it's a great game for couples, actually. I think it's a lot better with 2 than with 4, so one for couples. The next game I have is more of a social party kind of game, and it's called The Resistance Avalon by Indy. So this is a hidden identity type game for 5 to 10 players. And the idea is that you're each assigned a role, and some of you will be bad and some of you will be good. And together you'll try to win some quests, but the bad people have to fail the quest. So the good people have to detect who the bad people are, and the bad people just have to stay low and try to give blame to the other people, and it's so much fun. A lot of fun. You can learn a lot about your friends through this. Some good things, some bad things, but yeah, depending on the group of people that you're with, this will definitely be a hit. And finally, the last game I want to talk to you about today is one you may have heard of, and it's called Magic the Gathering. Magic the Gathering is one of the oldest and most popular trading card games ever. It's what Hearthstone was based off of, if you play that. But if you like Hearthstone and you want the physical experience of that, I would definitely recommend getting into Magic. You don't have to spend a lot of money, you don't have to buy really rare cards and have really amazing decks. If you just want to play on an amateur level with just your friends, you don't have to spend a lot of money into it, regardless of what people say. For those of you who are curious, this is my deck. It's a black and white deck, mostly black, like my soul. It's nothing special, it's just something I put together out of the pool of cards that I had available to me. I also have in here the die. It's a 20-sided die. This is basically your life counter, so you definitely need one of these unless you like doing math in your head every time you lose life points or gain life points. So you pretty much need a die. You don't need 2 die, you need a die. That came out a bit wrong, but yeah. I really hope you liked this video, and I hope that people who have never played board games before will be a bit more inclined to pick one up in the future and play with their friends and have a really nice time. And if you do play board games already, please let me know what are some of your favorites, what would you recommend. I have a list of board games I have to buy. It's like a 20 game list out of everything I've seen so far. It's like 20 best games that I really need to own, but they are expensive, so I'm not gonna spend all my money on this just yet. Also, another thing, if you are interested in board games and you don't know these channels, I will give you some quick recommendations of channels you should watch in order to get a bit more information and see more games and decide what you would like to try. But yeah, thanks so much for watching, and thanks for listening to me ramble about board games. I think they are really fun. I think you should try them. And yeah, that's it. Play more board games. Bye.